Hi, guys.
Okay, so here is my paper bag house. Now, from the front, it may not look like a paper bag, but what's cool about it is that it's standing up and it's kind of 3D. So that is why I used a paper bag. So if I turn it to the side, you can definitely see how I did that. The bag, you know, the bottom is what makes it stand up. And so that open part of the bag is at the top. And I actually glued like a color piece of paper onto the front of the bag because I didn't want my house to be brown. But you could do that yourself. You could add any color you want, or you could draw or glue right onto the bag too. Whatever works for you. Some houses are brown, or you know, buildings are all different colors. So have fun with it. You can also see that, you know, for our unit, we had to learn about shapes. And so you can see tons of shapes on our house. I actually used rectangles for my shutters and my door, and so I cut those out of paper and just glued them on there. I also used a black marker and a ruler to make the grids inside my windows and the little lines inside my shutters. And if you look closely, you can see that I put glitter on there to make it look like it had snowed and they were kind of like the snow was sitting on my roof or my shutters. You could do that. It's kind of spring and almost summertime now, so you could maybe find another way to make yours more creative. I also added a wreath, but you could add lights. You could put some lights in your windows or furniture or a cat or flowers in the little windowsills. There's so many things that you could add. My yard is a little boring right now, but you can kind of see that I do have a rectangular street in the front of my yard. And I also made little yellow rectangle stripes as part of the middle of the street. The reason I did that is because when we are in school, I actually have all the kids line up their houses. We glue them down and we line up our little yards next to one another to build a community. And then that way all the streets kind of connect and it makes a little neighborhood. And I'm so sad that we won't get to do that in school, but we can make a virtual neighborhood. So you can totally make one of these at home. You don't have to have a yard. You don't have to use a brown paper bag. You could actually make paper stand up in a lot of different ways. So I was going to show you a couple different things, different techniques as well.
At first, I'll show you how to add the shapes to your paper bag, some folding and cutting techniques. And then I will also show you how to make some 3D sculpture techniques using paper, scissors, and glue. Okay, so a few basics when you're doing your paper bag. The first thing I always tell kids is make sure you look to see where the bottom of your bag is. Can't tell you how many times we've accidentally messed up and made our bags upside down. So the opening is the top, and this is where you're going to put your hand inside when you're ready to pop it out. And the bottom looks like this, where it has a little flap. Okay, so this is actually the back. So the back has the flap. So you want to flip your bag over and you want the flat side to be on the front where the opening is at the top. And again, that flap is on the back at the bottom. Once you have your bag, you can go ahead and start drawing directly on your bag, or you can cut out some shapes. So if you wanted a door, for example, you might cut out a rectangle and you can put that rectangle, use some glue, and you might want to think about it. Do I want my door in the middle of my house? Do I want it to the side so I have more room for a window over here? And so you kind of want to plan ahead. Let's say I stick it there. Then you'll want to use some different kinds of paper, different colors. If you don't have different colors of paper, you could actually make your own by coloring it with crayons or colored pencils too. So let's say I have another piece. Well, I don't necessarily want my window to be the same size as my door. So all I have to do is then cut it into a square. I could cut it into two, and then I might have two windows. And so you're just basically cutting and arranging shapes. So I might have a good spot for a window here, and I could save this one for another time or somewhere else in my bag. If I wanted to make some shutters, it's good to kind of measure ahead using your eyes and your brain, or even a ruler if you want, ahead of time to make things even or the same on both sides, or as we call symmetrical. So there's a few ways you could do it. You could just stick this guy right on here in the middle and glue him down. That would be a quick, easy fix like that. And then cut off the side that you don't want anymore. So that would look like this. Okay, make sure I have room on my bag and then kind of visually measure how much space I would need on both sides. I would glue my white paper onto my turquoise and then stick that guy right on there. And then that way it looks like I have shutters. If you don't like that look, all you have to do is measure. So you can actually glue this one on. And if you like a little thicker, you know, however you decide, you could do it that way too. Or you could just cut the little strip off and just make sure you have enough space. And then you can glue it on top. And then you can take this piece and actually lay it on top of another and then use that to measure for the other side. So I do a lot of that too to help keep things symmetrical. So that's a good way to make shutters like that. You can make the little lines inside the windows by using a marker, or you could even cut them out too. So I would just make a little crisscross. Like that. You could put a little hatch in the window, a little lock in there. Another thing that we do sometimes to make it look like glass is we put some little hash marks. And so sometimes that makes it look like the shine in the window or in the glass. You can give yourself some lines in your shutters. Just have fun with it. Try to keep them even and straight if you can. And if not, that's okay too. You could even make a 3D shutter or ones that open and close by folding. So using folding techniques, you can kind of pre-measure and use a fold. And then knowing that that's the space that I need, cut there. I would glue this part down so that it would open and close over my window. That's another thing that you could do too. There are so many fun ways you can make windows and doors, light fixtures, all kinds of stuff on your house. And I just hope, I don't want to like limit you too much. I just want you to have fun with it. So. All right, so one thing I wanted to show you was how to make a 3D tree. Okay, so I just took a piece of brown paper. You can really do any size, mine's kind of small. And then you're going to roll it up. Another thing you could use is a toilet paper roll, and those work great too. So you can see that if you roll it up like this, it will act like a tree. Like it's kind of hard to stick to your paper. So one way to get around this, to make it where you could glue it down to your yard, is to take a pair of scissors and to kind of cut some little slits into the bottom. And the trick about this is that you want them all to be about the same size. And I'll show you, I'm sorry about the video here. I've got a lot of online learning happening at home today. Hopefully you can see that. But you kind of want them, you want them to be similar in size and height. So when I roll that up, I can hold it still and I can actually flare out my pieces, the little slits and little pieces that I made from earlier. And those will just act like little tree trunk branches or the little parts that stick out in the yard. And then you will more successfully be able to glue that down into your yard. If you want to add the top part of your tree, like the green part, I just took a piece of green paper and kind of cut it like an organic shape. And you can glue that as well to the top of your tree. You could make it just for the front if you want, or you could actually glue it on like this. And then when you wrap it, it'll stay together better for you too. Here are some 3D paper sculpture techniques that might help you. With some scissors and a little bit of glue, it's amazing what you can do with paper, especially when trying to make 3D objects for your house. Feel free to pause the video if you need to see one up more closely. Thank you.
Now it's your turn to make some awesome paper bag art. Go have some fun, and don't forget to share those pics.